Joining me now, Hall of Fame first baseman and shortstop for the Chicago Cubs, Mr. Cub Ernie Banks. Let me just add a little to your resume. Presidential Medal of Freedom.
That's amazing. It's amazing.
How did you learn about it?
I got a call.
Who was on the other end?
It was the president when Valerie Jarrett. Valerie lived in Chicago, so she was the first to call.
So yes, what was that like? Were you in another universe at that point?
Yes, I was. Because really, Candy, my long-range goal, I share this with you, was to win the Nobel Peace Prize, me and with Oprah, to win it together. That's what my lifetime goal was.
You're on your way, apparently. Next stop? Yeah. Nobel Prize.
Wow.
And you are being honored with Oprah, and who else is in this elite group?
My other good friend is Bill Clinton.
Mm-hmm.
And Mr. Bradley.
Oh, it'll be a great day.
Yeah, it'll be a great day. And I'm just so thrilled to be associated with the people and the recognition and all the things we do in life is well known.
What is it about who you were as a baseball player and who you are now and what you became after baseball that makes everybody light up when I say, oh, you know who we're having on the show? Ernie Banks. From my children to the staff to tweets, it was just people going, Ernie Banks, you're having Ernie Banks on. What is it about you?
That's a good question. I really don't know. I tried to study this. I had audits with the Pope. I went to Washington with President Ford on Air Force One. I spoke to High President. I've done things that I'm amazed. I played golf with Bill Gates and Warren Buffett at Augusta National.
And they're sitting around saying, hey, you know who I played golf with? Ernie Banks. I'm going to ask you to sign a couple of these because I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, looking back over the years, how many of these baseballs do you think you've signed over time?
When I did it, I thought I signed baseball for everybody in the world. But more pictures of me has been taken than any other athlete has played sports. I've had a lot of pictures taken of me doing all kinds of things with
Rawlings actually owes you quite a bit. Since people are out purchasing these balls to get you to sign them. You came in from the Negro League just 3 years after Jackie Robinson. What did your family say to you at that time? How critical was their support for you going into baseball at a time when it was a pretty all-white sport?
Well, my mother was born in Louisiana. And Louisiana had a lot of mystic people, you know, that she was trained. So she sent me and my dad down to visit with this lady to tell fortunes. And my dad asked her two questions, you know, is he gonna play baseball or go in the army? She's gonna play baseball. And that's what I did.
Wow, so you all owe it all to a fortune teller.
That's right.
And your dad for paying for the fortune teller. So if you look at your career, I know if I say, what was the key to your success? You'd say training and practice, I worked hard. Set that aside. What soul makes so many people the best at what they do? What made you the best at what you did at that time?
Well, it was just doing it, just focusing on it my whole life. I'm the second child, 12 in my family, first boy. And I could focus better than anybody. Anybody who's successful in sports or business or anybody just can focus on that. When I played a game, I'd walk by my kids and, you know, Dad. But I was focusing on the game so much, it's just unbelievable.
You hit 512 home runs. You know better than I do, so correct me if I'm wrong, over the course of your career. So if you had a young hitter here, little boy, 8 or 9 or 10, what kind of one piece of advice would you give them on how to improve their game?
Yeah, one thing, and I told Lou Brock this. We roomed together. He came for the Cubs. And he asked me, he said, Ernie, what does it take to play baseball? I said, you got to learn to relax. He said, you can relax. I can't relax. I don't want to go back to Louisiana. I said, you just have to learn to relax. And that night at the game, he hit the longest home run ever hit in the Polo Grounds. He did it. Just relax. Sometimes we don't know that we'll relax, but that's what you have to do, even in tight situations. Now, I didn't play in the World Series. I never played in the championship game, so I missed that. I don't
you
know
did
what,
after
I don't,
many, many years with the Cubs. Right. Big regret for you, or
yes.
do you? Yeah, of
really
course.
It really is.
Of course.
And I talked to a lot of the guys, you know, Hank Aaron, Willie Mays, the guys that came when I did, Frank Robinson. And, you know, what is it like? I mean, it's just different right. in the World Series.
How many Lou Brocks are there over the course of your lifetime, young men that you've given advice to?
There's a lot. That's a lot. I my own children, I have twin boys, and I talk to them, they played, and you know, I just try to let them know, just learn to relax, just relax, just relax. Let it happen. Don't try to make it happen, just let it happen. Now also, this is quietly kept, you know, I was the first black manager, you know, when everybody was kicked out of the game and they gave me the lineup to manage the game. And
well, you were the first black player on the Cubs. Correct?
Yeah.
And then the first, like, manager.
Yeah.
So those are tough times, aren't they? I mean, exciting. It's exciting to be first, but there's a lot of pressure to that.
They were exciting, but I used a player that not many people like. His name is Joe Pepitone. You ever heard of that name?
I haven't.
But anyway, he played first base, played for the Yankees. He came to the Cubs. I used him as a pinch hitter against a left-handed pitcher. Normally, they don't do that. A left-hand hitter, hitting against a left-hand pitcher, they don't do that. So I used him against a left-handed pitcher. He got the hit to win the game, and that was it.
So that's what they call a good call by the manager, right? Let me ask you one last thing, and that is you're known as Mr. Cub. You can't think of the Cubs without thinking of you. You played in Chicago for 19 years. So where do you go for deep dish pizza?
I go to several places there, and one right near where I live, and I go there and picked up the other day, funny that you mentioned that, picked up a pizza, but it is, it's a wonderful place, good people, they're very friendly, they treated me real nice, and I just love being around them.
Yeah, and my guess is you've probably done more for them than they've done for you. But I'm glad it's been a mutual admiration society. I can't thank you enough for being with us here today. You have made me a hero at home, so I appreciate that.
Thank you very much.
And congratulations again on that honor from the president.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'll see you at Stockholm.
It's a deal.